A day after what's being called a historic summit between North Korea and United States, a decision in Pyongyang's favor.
The U.S. president expressed his intention to halt the U.S.-South Korea joint military exercises, which the DPRK side regards as provocation during a period of goodwill dialogue, and to offer security guarantees and lift sanctions as mutual relations improve through dialogue and negotiation.
People talking to foreign media expressed support for their supreme leader.
The meeting between the DPRK and the U.S. leadership in Singapore was a very great event that has great significance for reconciliation, peace, stability, and future prospects for the Korean Peninsula.
Tomorrow and the future of our country look bright because we have the Marshal who is leading the world's political trend on the Korean Peninsula, steering the wheel of history.
Helping steer the wheel of history was U.S. President Donald Trump, who took to his favorite medium. The world has taken a big step back from potential nuclear catastrophe. No more rocket launches, nuclear testing, or research. The hostages are back home with their families. Thank you to Chairman Kim. Our day together was historic. In a surprise concession at the summit, Donald Trump promised the suspension of U.S. military drills with South Korea. The move has caused anxiety in Japan.
None of the details have been decided, but we believe the U.S.-South Korea military drills are vital for the security of Northeast Asia. I would like to seek an understanding of this between Japan, the U.S., and South Korea.
It's hoped the U.S. Secretary of State's visit to Seoul on Wednesday will help clear the air. He's already indicated military exercises will resume if North Korea stops negotiating in good faith. After meeting South Korean and Japanese officials, Pompeo will head to China for more talks. While world leaders have welcomed the vaguely worded joint statement from the summit on complete denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula, a lot of questions remain about the agreement's implementation. It is Tian Shan, TRT World, Washington.